Hi, my name is Adwoa. In this video, we're looking at a little known, a little recognized cousin of HIV, a virus known as human T-cell leukemia lymphotrophic virus, or it may just be called human T-cell lymphotrophic virus. While you may not have heard of this virus, and in fact, many health agencies don't really focus a lot on this virus, it's not a virus that has a disease of an orphan status. In fact, it is estimated that it affects at least 5 to 10 million individuals worldwide. It has distributions in Japan, in Latin America, in the Caribbean, in parts of sub-Saharan Africa, particularly in Central Australia. It's one of those viruses that is known to be concentrated in pockets, in regions within a wider distribution. So for instance, in Central Australia, there's a study involving Gallo and a few other people where they found that there can be up to 45% of the adult population that has this virus. So how did we discover this virus? What characterizes this particular virus as a T-cell lymphotrophic virus? Well, the work started in 1965. Gallo was working at an NIH and he was focused on comparing human leukemic cells with normal leukocytes. He was using several assays. He was looking at normal leukocytes and looking at leukocytes that were cancerous, leukemic. And he wanted to work out what the differences were between them, characterize them. So he started off initially using enzymes of pyrimidine nucleoside and nucleotide metabolism, just detecting these enzymes between the two. Then he moved on to looking at tRNA species between the two. So the tRNA species and their corresponding aminoacyl tRNA synthesis in between the two cell types. And then finally, what yielded the most success for him was looking at DNA polymerases of the leukemic or cancerous cells versus the normal leukocyte cells. What triggered this kind of work was that in the 1970s, there were retroviruses were being studied because it had been shown that in some animals, these viruses caused cancer. And so at this time, the DNA polymerase or reverse transcriptase specifically from the retroviruses were discovered by Temin and colleague Mizutani, along with independent research by David Baltimore. You may have heard about David Baltimore. Yes, David Baltimore that discovered that DNA polymerases were carried by these viruses. And in their instances, they were called reverse transcriptase because they transcribed the RNA into DNA. So for Gallo, who was working on retroviruses characterizing the reverse transcriptase, this meant a convenient, inexpensive, and relatively sensitive assay for detecting retroviruses via detection of the reverse transcriptase. So with this work, human T-cell lymphotrophic virus became the first retrovirus that was shown to cause cancer in humans. And so if you have a look at the screen here, the T lymphocytes are the cells that are infected by this virus, and they specifically affect T cells. And T cells, for those of us that were not that familiar, are immune cells. So how does HTLV1 replicate? How does it infect cells and duplicate or replicate itself? Since HTLV1 is a retrovirus, the viral RNA genome is first transcribed into double-stranded DNA. And then the viral DNA is integrated into the host genomic DNA. The integrated virus is called a provirus, and it is transcribed and serves as a template to produce new viral particles. It's this provirus that's integrated into the host DNA, the host genome, that is used as a template to produce more viral particles. And a characteristic thing about this HTLV virus is that when it goes into your DNA, it actually does not just make more viral particles, but it just makes more copies of the cells that it has infected. So it creates clonal expansion of the infected cells. And here's the thing to note. Because the cell is actually making copies, because the virus is actually making copies of itself by clonally selecting for more of the cells that has it, you end up having the HTLV sequences being quite stable because now it's using the cell's DNA polymerase for expansion rather than its own reverse transcriptase, which is more likely to make errors. So what is this HTLV1 virus? What are some things that we know about it? Its genome is 9,000 base pairs long. The genome, the viral genome, has identical long terminal repeat or LTR sequences at both ends of the provirus. The 5' long terminal repeat acts as the promoter for the transcription in the sense orientation, while the 3' long terminal repeat is the promoter for the antisense transcription. If you need a little refresher on long terminal repeats, 5' and 3' end and DNA replication, there's a video on my site that you will be able to get bit expansion on, or you can just look at someone else's video. As long as you understand it, that's what matters. There are two regions of the genome that is worth noting. So TAX is encoded in the PX region, and this one is well-characterized viral protein and works as a transactivator of the HTLV1 5' long terminal repeat. The other protein to take note of is the HTLV1 BZIP factor, or HBZ. It's also encoded in the PX region, but in the antisense orientation. Now, both of these proteins are implicated in oncogenesis induced by HTLV1. Why should we pay attention to HTLV1? Why should we care? Well, the virus sporadically causes severe diseases, such as adult T-cell leukemia or lymphoma. Now, this is an aggressive form of cancer that, regardless of what you throw at it, it leads to the death of the person within a year of its detection. Now, thankfully, it only happens in about 5% of HTLV1 infected individuals. And this is why you probably don't hear much about HTLV1, unlike its more famous cousin, HIV. Now, in addition to this adult T-cell leukemia lymphoma, it can also cause other inflammatory diseases such as HTLV1-associated myelopathy or tropical spastic paraphernalia. And this happens in about 2% of individuals who have HTLV. So the inflammatory disorder is known by two names, but it's the same inflammatory disorder. It's HTLV-associated myelopathy or tropical spastic paraphernalia. And the major symptoms appear to be caused by damages to spinal neuronal cells by inflammatory T cells. And so people have difficulty in movement. How does this virus spread? So this virus, unlike its famous cousin, really needs cell-to-cell contact to spread. And so it tends to be more readily transmitted via what is referred to as vertical transmission, so a mother-to-child transmission when the mother is breastfeeding. Or it can also occur while during pregnancy, but it's not as likely. It tends to happen more during breastfeeding. Sexual transmission of the virus is also notable, as well as transmission, because there's this requirement for cell-to-cell transmission. Transmission of blood products that have not been screened can lead to infection, potential infection, if the blood had HTLV1 virus in it. So that's a quick wrap-up of this HTLV1 virus, human T-cell lymphotropic virus, which has distribution in a number of areas. It's endemic in a number of areas in the world and can cause an aggressive form of cancer, adult T-cell leukemia or adult T-cell lymphoma, and its transmission is via breastfeeding, sexual contact, or through blood products if they have not been screened.